つでも唱えとけ。
あまり時間がねえ。早いとこ済ませてんだがな。
Sega sent me the code for Yakuza 6, the Song of Life, and I got a great big smile on my face because I have grown to really love the Yakuza series, and this is the most up-to-date version of this franchise. It's brand new, has, you know, amazing visuals, the best visuals that we've seen in this franchise. Really, really cool character designs. We're following the exploits of Kazuma Kiryu, the same guy that we've been watching all the way through the Yakuza games, although this time he feels like he's trying to kind of reform. He takes responsibility for some of his duplicitous actions in the past and goes to prison, serves his sentence, and he's sort of away from the people that he cares about and loves for 3 years. And he comes out and he realizes that one of the people that he really loves has been hit in a hit and run accident and is in a coma in the hospital, and he has to take care of her baby. And so Kiryu is this guy that suddenly he's like Mr. Mom, and it's a very strange direction in a game series that is just rife with strange directions.
この子はハルカの子だ。
Yakuza, as we all know, is kind of like a it's like a mini game collection. Like, there's just so many different things that you can do, that you can spend a lot of time doing, that are not the main through line of the experience. You can play arcade games, of course, the Sega, you know, staples like Super Hang-On and OutRun are in there, but then also Virtual Fighter 5 is in here, which is insane, and Puyo Puyo, and you can play them two player as well, which is crazy. You can play baseball, you can play darts, you can have conversations with hostesses and hostess bars, there's karaoke, you can go you know, fishing underwater, there's home run derbies. It's a ton of things that will capture your attention, and this is the way that you play this game. It's like you sit down, you say, okay, I'm gonna like solve some stuff, I'm gonna get into the story a little bit here, and then you get into a fight because you do a ton of fighting. Like, almost everything is solved in the sort of the main story plotline stuff by kicking the crap out of gang members. You beat up drunks, you beat up triad people and lots of Yakuzas and just tough guy idiots that think they can take down Kiryu-san, but they cannot, and he just demolishes lots and lots of people in here. And you pick up bicycles and signs and baseball bats and anything that you can find around you, swords, and you just waste people. You do a lot of that, but then you see a little dot, or maybe you see a little controller symbol on the map and you go, well, I wonder what's in there. And then you go in there and then you find yourself playing darts for 4 hours. And then you go, okay, that's enough of that. And then you like walk over and there's a cute little kitty and you're like, well, I gotta feed this cat. So you go buy some cat food and then you feed the cat. And all of it is sort of adding to the experience points, but also, you know, the latent fun and experience of playing a Yakuza game. And they're so weird and quirky and funny, and you know, there's also like this really sort of human and drama infused, you know, plot thread all the way through here. Like, you have to really start to care about this little baby that you're taking care of. There are mini games where you're like lifting the kid and swinging the kid, you know, you got to get milk for the kid, you don't want it to be screaming. And you actually have this whole other diversion where you go to Hiroshima, so you've got stuff that's sort of set in Tokyo, and then you also go to this more a smaller town with a different kind of setup, with different kinds of people, still incredibly violent Yakuza-led people, and you get sort of sucked into the underbelly. And there's also a lot of empathetic souls and people that kind of feel for you and understand your plight. You just want to take care of the people that you care about. It works on all of these different levels against your better sense, you know, because there's a lot of really long expository cut sequences. Thankfully, you can skip through a lot of the dialogue that just takes a long time to get through. Like, it's okay, I get it. It's beautifully rendered, it's really nice, but you see a lot of the same repeated themes and a lot of the same types of conversations, a lot of the same sort of encounters, like same things happen as you encounter these people over and over again. But you also get sucked in. This is a great game. Again, I'm hooked, man. I think Sega has got a lovely franchise with the Yakuza games, and they're very hard to put down. I mean, I do feel like because I've dipped into this well a few times now on this system, I kind of get it. I wish they would maybe take a little breath. Like, I was playing a little bit of Kiwami not too long ago and I reviewed Yakuza 0. So a little breath now before we get more, but still, hard to disqualify Yakuza 6 as anything less than really, really fun. I'm gonna give Yakuza 6 an 8.5 out of 10.